So you ran into a SOF 404 error and you're here to find out how you can solve it. We got you. In this video, we're going through the common issues and fixes for the SOF 404 error. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that provides easy to use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to help you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. All right, before we talk about the fixes, we've got to understand what soft 404 means and how it differs from the regular 404 error. So for the regular 404, when you try to access a web page that does not exist, your browser will send a request to the server for the web page. However, the server can't find that page, so it sends back a 404 status code. Your browser would then show you the 404 not found page, indicating that the page is unavailable. Now, as for SOF 404, when you try to access a web page, the browser sends the request to the web server and the server found that page and returns a 200 OK status code, just like any other pages on your site. However, the content of the page may not be helpful to the visitor, as it might be a page with a note saying, this product is out of stock, the product is unavailable, no results found, or it is a page with little to no content. In this case, though the server interprets it as a 200 OK status code like any other pages, search engines interpret the page as a soft 404. This is because from the search engine's perspective, the page does not provide valuable content and is similar to a page not found situation, despite being technically available. So when you're fixing the soft 404 error, the key is to make sure that the pages that are supposed to be 404s remains as is and is not flagged as soft 404s. And for those pages that are supposed to be indexed, do not fall in the soft 404 category. Now, if you already know that the error exists on your site, look at the timestamps in the description to skip ahead for the solutions. And if you don't know if the error exists on your site, let's talk about how you can identify the error. On your search console, under the indexing category, you want to click on pages. Scroll down and you will see a list of errors on why your pages aren't indexed. If you have the SOF 404 error on your site, you will see it here. Click through it and you will see which page the error is referring to. And from here, you can start resolving the issue on this page. Now, if you are using RankMath, you don't have to visit the Google Search Console because you can access the data right from your site. On your dashboard, hover to RankMath SEO and select the Analytics module. And now we are at the Analytics dashboard. To check out the index status of your pages, hover over this tab where it says Index Status and click on it. Now, if you haven't connected your Google Analytics and Search Console with your site, or you do not see the Index Status tab in the module, we recommend that you follow this video right here to get everything set up. The link is in the description. Anyway, once you are on the Index Status tab, you will see an overview of the indexing performance of the pages on your site, and you will be able to filter out the pages based on the issues that are found on your Google Search Console. So the SOF 404 error is right here. Let's select that, and you will see those pages with the SOF 404 error. Now, with the Google Search Console, you will get the indexable information of everything, which includes the indexable pages, archive pages, feed pages, query parameters, and more, and it could get overwhelming. But if you're looking for indexable information for important pages, such as your posts, pages, or custom post types, then the RankMath Analytics module will be useful for you. All right, now that you know what SOF 404s are and how to identify them, let's talk about the ways to fix the SOF 404 error. Now, these are some main causes of a SOF 404 error, and we'll talk about them one at a time. Now, the first thing to check is if your web server settings is configured to return a 404 error for missing pages. If your server is not configured correctly, it may return a 200 status code instead of a 404, which will cause Google and other search engines to index the page even though it doesn't exist. So to check if your web server is configured correctly, on the browser, you want to type in a URL that does not exist. For example, at the back of the domain name, I will enter some gibberish and hit enter or return. As we can see, it shows that this page can't be found. But what about the HTTP status code? Now, I'm working on Google Chrome, but you can use other web browsers to perform this check as well. They are rather similar. Let's right-click on the page and select Inspect. This will bring up the developer tools. Now, in our case, the developer tools appear at the bottom, but for some of you, it might appear on the right. So a simple click on these three dots, and you can adjust how you want your developer tools to appear. Now, what you want to do is to click on the network tab. In case you can't find it, you have to click on this double arrow and you should see it. And then you want to refresh the page. And you will see all the elements of the page being loaded. These elements are producing a 200 status code, some are JavaScripts, and some are CSS style sheets, but they are not our focus. Let's scroll to the top, and this is what we are looking for. This is the page. As you can see, the type is a document, and it is producing a 404 status. This means that the web server is configured correctly. But if this is producing a 200 status code, and if you are not a technical person, the best is to contact your server support and ask for assistance with configuring the 404 status. There are some lines of code that need to be added, and they should know what they are. Now, if the server setting is not the issue, then the next step is to assess the purpose, importance, and the intent of the soft 404 page. Now, if the content on one of your pages is outdated and you have updated the content on a new page, for example, if you have updated some parts of your content of this page and you did it on a different page with a different URL, you should never delete this outdated page or let it run normally on your site. You should do a 301 redirect if you don't want your users or search engines to find this page anymore. So when a person visits this old page, be it through the search engines or from other websites, they will automatically be redirected to the new page. To do a 301 redirect on RankMath, let's say that this is the old page with this URL, and we want to redirect people from this page to another page with this URL. What you want to do is to go to RankMath's dashboard, make sure that the advanced mode at the top right is selected, and also you want to make sure that the redirections module is toggled on. As soon as you have done that, you will see the redirections module on the menu. Let's click on it, and this is where you can manage all the redirections on your site. Let's click add new. The source URL will be the URL of the old page. So let's go to that page, copy this URL back to the redirections module, and paste the URL here. Now the destination URL will be the URL of the new page. So let's go to the new page, copy this URL, and similarly, let's paste it here. As for the redirections type, you want to select 301 permanent move so that this page will permanently be redirected to this page. Next, let's keep the status active and add the redirection. Once you have done that, as we go to the old page and refresh it, take note of the change in the URL. Let's click refresh and it will be redirected to the URL of the new page. Now, if you have lots of URLs that need to be redirected, don't do it one by one. Do it in the bulk. Check out this video to learn how to do that. The link is in the description. Now, if the soft 404 page is an archive, tag, or category page that has zero content, for example, if you have this category page that has zero articles in it, if you visit the page, there will be nothing on it. Also, if you go to the tag pages, we have these tag pages without any content. These pages may be flagged as soft 404. So to avoid that, you want to hover over RankMath SEO, select titles and meta. Under the global meta, you will see this option where it says no index empty category and tag archives. This setting is turned on by default, but if you see that this is off, you want to turn it on and click on save changes. Doing that will make sure that those empty archive pages will be marked with the no index meta tag, and the search engines will know that they should not index those pages. This will eliminate the soft 404 on those pages as well. Now, if a page is marked as soft 404, and when you visit the page, it has little to no content, in other words, thin content pages, there are two options. One is to add more content to the page and make it more helpful to your site visitors. Or number two, if you don't really need that page, do a 301 redirection to a page that is more helpful to your site visitors. Now, for some legit reasons, you need the duplicated pages to be available to your site visitors. Maybe it is a product attribute page, a printer-friendly version of a page, and they are flagged as a soft 404. You want to add a canonical URL to those pages. For example, in terms of product pages, you have a main product page, and out of the product, there are many variations. For example, the blue or the red version of the product. Each product page will have its own unique URL. And since the contents of the pages are identical, search engines may view them as duplicated pages and may flag them as soft 404. So what you want to do is to add a canonical URL to these pages telling search engines that this is the main page they should index and consider these two pages as versions of the same product. If you use RankMath on the WordPress editor of any posts or pages, click on the RankMath tab, select the advanced settings, and over here, you can add the main page URL in this field, telling search engines that this URL is the main page and this page you are on is a duplicated version of the main page. Now, if the Soft 404 page is a product page and you use WooCommerce with RankMath, you may want to check out this video as we've discussed the fixes in detail. The link is in the description. Now, if the Soft 404 page is with helpful content, it is not a thin content page, a duplicated page, or none of the above, then the Soft 404 error could be caused by Ajax loading. Ajax loading is a JavaScript function that allows web pages to update parts of the page without needing to refresh the whole page. This makes the website faster and more interactive. The simplest example is if you have pagination on your page, as you click the next page, only this part of the page refreshes and not the entire page. That's the power of Ajax. The Ajax function can also be used on private or subscription content, as well as pages with read more or load more functions. So if the main content of your Soft 404 page is part of the Ajax loading function, you may want to consider bringing more of the main content out of the Ajax function and put it on the main page itself. So when a search engine scrolls your page, the main contents will be available to them instantly. There you have it. I hope with this video, you will have a clear understanding of how you can fix the Soft 404 issue. And if you find this video helpful, how about smashing that thumbs up button? And if you're new to our channel, we are all about helping you grow your search traffic, so subscribe to us. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.